his last shift. It was one of those for the ages, Doc. Unbelievable shift on short-handed. Three against five. Ruslan Fedotenko with a couple of tremendous plays. A sweeping
Unless you take a 2-1 lead in the series. What a time to bump a slump. Second goal of the playoffs for Marian Gaborik, who hadn't scored in 8. Richards set him up, and the Rangers take the series lead.
Well, you sense the little swing of energy when you get the puck down low. Richards made a great play just inside the blue line to keep a bouncing puck alive, and a quick reverse. Earlier we saw Gaborik with the same type of a play that went off the post. This time, good position in front. And all of a sudden, a burst of energy from a man who is having a hard time putting the puck in the net, as you mentioned.
Here's the numbers that jump out to me, guys. And it's 40 career goals for Marian Gaborik. Now that's 41. Only 2-game winners. There's the second. And the other is the pass. Richards has been involved in 44% of the Rangers' offense. The number gets better with that pass.
Right off the stick, almost there for the 5-hole by Holtby. You saw how close that pass by Richards was of getting picked off as well. Look at the desperation by Carlson, just barely misses it. Beagle can't get there in time, and a deflated Holtby after what was a great game all around. And the exuberance of winning.
Marian Gaborik's first ever playoff game winner at 14-41 of the third overtime period. And Glenn Sather and the New York Rangers take a 2-1 lead in the series heading into game 4 on Saturday afternoon at the
Washington will take the offensive punch out of the Rangers' game.
They're starting to come out here, and the Rangers towards the end. But look, they're playing with the puck. They're supporting the strength and numbers in the offensive zone. Much easier to play with the puck. Here's Brian Boyle with it. Angle one back towards the rush. That's from the next one.
Thank you.
good read by the Rangers. They take the board away. They jump on the loose puck. Said, how do you get away from a team that shot blocks full up? Fake the shot. Henrik commits himself too quickly. One of the rare bad goals that goes in on Holtby. He's got a screen in front of him, a bad angle shot, and this one just fools a five-hole.
They are a collapsed team, Washington. They'll have sometimes all of their players almost...
Puck is dropped. Callahan has it. Callahan turns and shoots. It's blocked by the stick of light. Haglund to the far corner. Up the boards, Gabbert with 12 seconds. Out to the point, Delzano. Delzano shoots. It's blocked. Comes in front. Callahan with a chance. It's stopped. Rebound.
To the boards, and it comes back to Stahl, and Stahl does a nice job of kind of teeing things up, getting a lay of the landscape. Anisimov heads to the net, Stepan heads to the net, and the board erupts. Oh my God. As the fireworks go off here, and a little bit of a delay call. In the box. Oh, you like that? For the Rangers, time ball. In overtime ball.
7 in Boston. Scored the overtime goal, which 11 energy, the defending Stanley Cup champion, Boston Bruins. Mama knew I was a needle in a haystack. Upper body boy, plus made back. I got a feeling it's a wrap. ASAP.
Boston Capitals pulled a fastball. This is what they put on the video board. Take us to the next round as if the Rangers believe they're already getting through. Pretty cool. All fair. Good point of the season. Richards beats the draw. Number 74 right off his hip and passed to an outstretched Holtby with a body all over. We haven't seen Gabbert shoot very much from out there.
Get it.
coming to the bench now as it's led over to Carlson. Simmons played it ahead. Blocked Play. Down. Held to the outside. Sure. Locked on back. And it is regathered back there. And can be played over by Hammerling. Building. Tried by Kreider.
Up, I just laugh, put my kicks up on they desk, unaffected by they threats, then get busy on they ass. See, that's how that shit down made me, that's how my daddy raised me. That glittering may not be gold, don't let nobody play me. If you are my homeboy, you never have to pay me. Don't even put your hands up, in times it's how you stand up. Hell, you be the man, cause a brand that the fans trust. So even if they ban us, they'll never slow my plans up. There. Three in the air for the kids in the ghetto. Four for the kids that don't wanna be there. None for the niggas tryna hold him back. Five in the air for the teacher not scared to tell those kids that's living in the ghetto that the niggas holding back, that the world is theirs. Yeah, yeah, the world is yours. I was once that little boy, terrified of the world. Now I'm on a world tour. I will give up everything, even start a world war for these ghetto girls and boys. I'm rapping around the world for Africa to New York, Haiti then I detour, Oakland out to Oakland. Gaza Strip to Detroit, say hip-hop only destroy. Tell them look at me, boy. I hope your son don't have a gun and never be a D-boy. You've been through, no matter what you into, no matter what you see when you look outside your window. Brown grass or green grass, picket fence or barbed wire, never ever put them down. You just lift your arms higher, raise them till your arms tired. Let them know you here, that you struggling, surviving, that you gon' persevere. Yeah, ain't nobody leaving, nobody going home. Even if they turn the lights out, the show is gonna on.
14 straight games in which the Rangers had three goals or less. 14 straight in which they allowed three goals or less. And now on to New Jersey. And the Devils here on the
except for that tie back in the second period. The Capitals really had a surge against the Rangers. Other than that, the Rangers really played to their strengths. Initiating contact in the corners, blocking shots. The forwards did a wonderful job of coming back and helping out the defense, taking away the area in the middle of the ice. And Lundqvist had to be really huge in that second period. I still look back, Doc, in this third period with that 3-on-2, that chance for Ovechkin when the game was 1-0, and he missed the net. A real gutsy performance by both teams, but the Rangers, the matchup, game 7 at home, stepped to the forefront to get an opportunity
to take on the Devils on Monday night. Pierre on the ice with Brad Richards.
Thanks a lot, Doc. You win a game 7 against Boston, you win a game 7 against Washington, now you're going to the Eastern Conference Final. What's the key to doing that?
Well, we played this way all year. It hasn't been easy. It's been tight all year long, so we're used to these, but we'd like to do it a little different. But it's still a great experience for everybody.
You were brought in because you've got the magic touch when it comes to winning games. What were you thinking when your team took the penalty late in the game on the bench?
You know what, it was just kind of the way we do things. We never make it easy, and we're up to nothing, and we kind of let them get back in it. But, it was a battle right there.
People say that Game 7 pressure, especially on home ice, can eat some teams up. It clearly doesn't eat you guys up. Why?
I think it's great. You know, this was a big matchup series. We got some matchups we like. We don't play it here. This is a great, New York City. We bet on it. It can work both ways, but we did a good job with it.
The one that Stanley Cup and Oprah in Tampa, you really haven't been close since. Is your team good enough to win the Cup now?
Yeah, I mean, all four are great teams right now, and everybody has the same chance. Jersey's probably playing as good as anybody in the playoffs, so it's going to be a challenge, but we believe just as much as the other three teams.
Thanks for your time. We'll see you for Game 1 of the Eastern Final on Monday, Brad.
All right, Pierre. Thanks.
Final score in the game, Brad Richards and his New York Rangers 2, the Washington Capitals 1 in a 7th game thriller. Coming up tomorrow, the 2012 Stanley Cup playoff presented by Geico. Continue with Game 1 of the Western Conference Final between the Kings and the Coyotes right here on the NBC Sports Network. It was Richards a long time ago, 1-0. Del Zotto, 2-0, midway in the third. 38 seconds later, that one answered by Hammerlick and pressed as much as they could. It could not be equal. 2-1 Rangers, the Bud Light post game after these messages.